In a setback for the Delhi police, the Delhi High Court has dismissed a plea by the Ministry of Home Affairs, which sought clarification of the court's order on the clash between lawyers and policemen on last Saturday. The centre had sought to clarify that the protection to lawyers was extended only with respect to the two FIRs which were filed after the Teez Hazari violence and not the subsequent clashes in other courts. The High Court also dismissed another plea of police seeking permission to lodge FIR against lawyers in the Saket District Court incident. The lawyers' counsel told the court that the police are misusing their power and both media and the police are trying to spoil their case.
Amid the standoff over government formation in Maharashtra, senior Shiv Sena leader Sanjay Raut met NCP chief Sharad Pawar in Mumbai on Wednesday. The meeting comes after speculations that Sena is trying to woo the NCP to come together to form the next government. This as the BJP and Shiv Sena continued to be locked in a bitter tussle over sharing of the chief minister's post and ministerial portfolios. While Raut dismissed the meeting as a curtsy call, Pawar maintained that the mandate to form the next government is still with the BJP-Sena combined.
Pawar saab, desh ke Maharashtra ke bade neta hai, margadarshak hai. उन्हें भी चिंता है कि राज्य में अब तक सरकार क्यों नहीं बन रहा है, राज्य में अस्थिरता है।
The Supreme Court on Wednesday denied bail to 1984 riots convict Sajjan Kumar. Former Congress leader's lawyer argued in court that Kumar has lost 8 to 10 kg of weight in Tihar jail in the past 11 months. The court, however, observed that losing weight is not an ailment and directed that Kumar should be examined by a panel of AIIMS doctors. The top court directed the listing of his bail and his appeal in summer vacation next year.
A video released by Pakistan government to welcome Sikh pilgrims to Kartarpur shows posters of Khalistani separatist leaders Jarnail Singh Bhindranwale, Major General Shahbag Singh and Amrit Singh Khalsa in the background in one part. All three were killed when the Indian Army stormed Golden Temple in June 1984 in Operation Blue Star to free it from terrorists' hold inside. The development comes in the wake of repeated fears expressed by Punjab CM Captain Amrinder Singh and intelligence agencies that Pakistan could use the Kartarpur corridor to revive militancy in Punjab.
ये वही बातें हैं जो मैं पहले दिन से कह रहा हूं कि पाकिस्तान का हिडन एजेंडा है.
With stubble burning being considered the main reason for pollution in North India, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal said it is technologically and commercially possible to convert stubble into CNG. Kejriwal, who said he had several meetings with experts on the issue, wrote in a tweet that it requires all governments to come together and work on this. The Kejriwal government has been accusing Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana of not taking concrete steps to solve the issue of stubble burning in states which increases pollution in Delhi NCR. The Sensex jumped 222 points to settle at its new lifetime high of 40,469.78 on Wednesday, led by robust gains in bank stocks. After opening on a choppy note, the Sensex touched an all-time intraday high of 40,606.91 in late afternoon trade. It finally ended 221.55 points higher at 40,469.78. Similarly, the NSE Nifty briefly reclaimed the 12,000 level before finishing at 11,966.05, showing a gain of 48.85 points or 0.41%. Benchmark indices have been on a rising spree on the back of strong earnings, hope for another economic booster from the government and positive cues from global markets.
Actor Swara Bhaskar is facing severe backlash after she described her experience of working with a four-year-old child actor using vulgar words. The video from the chat shows son of Abhish has gone viral and an NGO, Legal Rights Protection Forum, has reportedly filed a complaint to the National Commission for Protection of Child Rights and demanded action be taken against Swara.